and she went out to get some.
We got a beer.
Real kills.
Yeah. Yeah. She get her top blown off.
I mean, she had to. You playing video games?
Yeah.
Or you eating pizza?
And you find out, right? Mm-hmm. And you've been cheating the whole time.
Oh. Right? You've been stepping out. You got a gamer. You got a gamer joint.
You've been stepping out the whole time. Would you expose her on it? Like, would you like, yo, call her out? Like, yo, I found out you was cheating, you raggedy bitch. You funky dog head bitch.
Fuck them hoes. They don't know that you're worth it, babe.
Everybody good? Nobody got the corona? Everybody all right?
Yeah, I'm good on
the corona. All right, cool. Straight.
I got a red stripe.
Welcome back to the Blunt Exchange. Episode 18?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
I am your host, Aim Gunner, a.k.a. Gregory Hines, the great dance legend, a.k.a. Aim High, Stay Fly, Low Life. To my left, I got none other than my guy.
One hell of an introduction.
Yo, what's poppin', everybody? It's your boy, Crump, a.k.a.
A.k.a. The Robot. A.k.a. Dexter. A.k.a. I controls my woman.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
To my right, I got none other than... Oh, wait a minute.
What?
What's good?
What? I'm protected.
Okay.
I don't drink Coronas. Fuck that.
To my right, I got none other than the man, the myth, the legend.
Pablo, a.k.a. Bleak.
A.k.a. the Wavy Seal. Woo. A.k.a. I'm not letting no pussy pass me because I got to do what I do as a man, and that's smash.
Woo! Champ is here.
Hulk smash.
Huh?
So, guys.
Talk to me.
How was the week?
My week was cool. It was pretty mundane.
Mundane. That's a nice word. I like that.
I mean, I try and
jazz it up a little bit. Yeah, y'all been reading. Y'all been reading.
Yo, man, Hooked on Phonics works. It works. Okay. So.
Bleak, how was the vacation? I know you coming back. How was the motherland? How was the motherland?
I just flew back, bro. I got to protect y'all.
Okay. How was the motherland?
Motherland was amazing.
What'd you do out there, man?
I was chilling, you know, with Dub Work.
Shout out Dub Work. Happy birthday again.
It was his birthday. Shit was crazy. Fred was out there with us.
Okay, shout out Fred Focus, Prince of New York, one of the best directors in the city.
Another boy of ours, Gabs, was out there.
Gabs, you know, photographer extraordinaire. Mm. You know,
it was great. It was amazing.
So you had fun. Great time.
OD, man.
Was it like a boys trip? You went out there with?
Yeah, definitely.
You know when I? Okay,
it was just us. You know,
what y'all do?
You know, we was out there
eating good,
digging up our ancestors.
Infantunde.
You know
which
what
means
I mean?
Destiny returned.
So the ancestors give you a new name?
I can't reveal it yet.
Yeah, okay. I'm gonna come up. I have some names for you guys. We're gonna get to that. But you had fun, good food, good eats.
Everything. But let me tell you, man, the airport scare is for real.
Talk to me.
There's nobody out there.
It was empty?
It was empty.
So you didn't get the round of applause when you landed in DR like you normally get?
Nah.
The DR tradition?
In DR you did. In DR, because they nobody's sick. Regardless. Nobody's sick in DR. But trust me, bro. That shit looked... It was a dead zone, you know? Because usually, I landed and I took off from JFK, so that's a very popular airport.
Yeah.
Right. And that shit, there was no one in there. You know, it was very, very, very low-key.
Okay.
Probably spent... Like, you know how they tell you be there 2 hours, 3 hours? This time around, you could be there an hour before. Okay. Getting through.
Just go easy.
Easy.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Easy
peasy.
Yeah, ain't nothing happening.
Yeah, easy breezy.
That sounds good.
How was your week, G?
My week was... It was, you know, it's always a good week. And you're healthy. And we get to another show. It's always a great week. You know what I mean? So nothing special happened this week, but next week is my birthday week.
It's a champion. It's a
Pisces,
champion
stand up. We about to get it in. You heard?
Yep.
You heard? Next week's going to be crazy. You better be here. If you're a Blunt Exchange fan and you follow us from the beginning, you got to be here next week. Next week is going to be a crazy week.
I see you in that all green, yo. You're looking real...
what is it with that Boston hat?
Real,
It just matches, Bleak.
Real March.
Cool. I respect that.
Yeah. Well, you know, green is March. Green makes you think of March because of St. Patrick's Day.
Well, yeah.
That's what it is.
And in particular... Your birthday is on St. Patrick's Day.
Well, it's St. Gary's Day. But,
St. Gary.
You know.
We changed that 30 plus years ago.
Yeah, we've been changed that.
Yeah.
Guys, I want to get into some current events first today.
Oh, no, mm-hmm. Word of the day?
You want to do word of the day first?
Yeah, let's feel dumb real quick.
No, but you guys have been doing good recently.
I know.
So it can't be that bad.
It's you know. Yo, shout out my man Kenny in the building.
Facts.
Real quick. Shout out my man
Kenny. Looking for pulling up.
Pulling up. Yeah. But shout out Left in the studio. As always, Engineer Left. Shout out Engineer Left.
Working on his new music. Got some new hot shit.
Dropped that Paris and Maryland.
Woo!
I mean,
you dig?
I think he got a video out too, right?
You dig. He got a little nice little video. Him with a little shorty in the back of the cab jump.
Heat.
I mean, hollering at shorty.
You know what I mean? Putting her onto game.
Yeah.
That's the worst thing you can do. Put a chick onto game.
Made it sure so she bagged him.
Why is that the worst
him.
Thing?
You
huh?
dig?
Why?
I mean, it depends. It depends what kind of game you're putting her onto, and it also depends the girl.
Word of the day. You guys ready?
Yeah.
The word of the day today is pejorative.
What?
Pejorative.
Pejorative. Pejorative. Sounds like a verb or something.
Some people pronounce it pejorative. Pejorative.
All right. So I'm going to give you a guess just off of the name itself, and then I want to hear the sentence. But just what pejorative. It's like an adjective,
it's
right?
An adjective.
It's an adjective. Okay.
Yeah, honestly, I've only gotten really good at knowing what the difference between like adjectives and like nouns are recently. I've always known what a verb is, but grammar was never really my grammar was never really my thing. But
manifest that. Sometimes when you speak that shit, you make yourself, you know what I mean?
No, I understand.
Don't manifest it, because you are
I'm
good.
I'm getting better at it.
No,
I'm,
you
I'm
are good.
No, you are good.
You just don't trust yourself.
Right. So pejorative means argumentative, maybe?
Argumentative?
Wow, that's I don't good. Like.
That's not bad.
It sounds like if somebody was like, "Yo, man, you're being real pejorative right now." Like,
you have something
negative. I always think something's negative. It sounds negative, so I'm gonna say something negative.
The word sounds what
demeaning? You, demeaning, you, maybe. Talk down.
What do you have, Bleak?
Projevit, right?
Pejorative.
Pejorative.
You guys want the sentence?
Yeah, please. For the.
Do you want to give
the,
a guess before?
No. let's do it for the listeners.
Oh, for the listeners. Yeah. Strictly for the listeners. Permissiveness is used almost universally as a pejorative term. I'm not going to lie to you, Crump. I think you know it.
Yeah, you on the money on that.
I think you're on the money.
I think I'm going to take a step back on this one.
Like, just throw something out there, Bleak. Just so you
have ultimately, like you know how like women will like how that. I'm not saying it just happens between women. Men do it also.
Because 2020 is the year of the woman, and we love you, women.
Yes, I'm just saying. But when one sex and the same sex like talks down about the other person to either make themselves look better or make the other person look bad, like because I heard the promiscuous like thing and. It's normally somebody else calling somebody else promiscuous in order to, like...
Even though I said permissive, but it can be used...
Oh, permissive. I'm sorry.
It can also be... Listen.
I'm dumb.
To be honest with you, you're right.
Okay.
You got it right.
Okay, cool.
Second week in a row, you got it.
Man, I didn't even need to cheat.
Pejorative.
I didn't even need to cheat this time. I was about to write the answers on some chips. I saw that on the internet
Dorito chips?
Yeah, I saw a meme where this person wrote mad, like... answers to the test on Dorito chips right and like place them back
and
in the bag.
And that's all good until you're like in the middle of the test and you're like,
yeah. Oh, I forgot to. I didn't answer those questions yet. Those are the next set.
Doritos
questions.
Just taste so good. You're just gonna eat them. Like, oh shit.
Yo, you know what's crazy?
That was the end of the
you
test.
You know what's crazy?
That was the open end of the test.
You shouldn't even eat Dorito chips
because they're cardboard.
There's like they nothing. Catch on fire. There's nothing. There's nothing like.
Can we answer the word of the day and we get to
that? Oh yeah, sure.
I think
you said
I got it. So
you got
that's
it right.
Like,
so I'm gonna give you the actual definition.
Let's go.
So pejorative.
Yes.
Pejorative.
Uh-huh.
It's an adjective,
yes.
And it means expressing contempt or disapproval.
Woo! Damn, Crump.
Synonyms, disparaging, derogatory.
Oh, yeah, that was me.
You got it.
That was me.
That was all you.
So,
came up, that's...
So, if you have any examples of pejorative language, you know, we should bring them up. Like
bring
it up. Is Wendy Williams... pejorative
I think
in her
so.
Language?
Just in general?
General. I think that's her brand.
Yeah.
And then I've seen recently she was talking about...
her husband.
One of the greatest rappers of all time.
Yeah.
And she was...
Rappers or greatest female rappers?
I didn't make that distinction. Okay. If that's something that you feel like that has
to be
made.
I was just asking.
I'm just saying one of the greatest rappers of all time.
Okay. She is.
She didn't need to be differentiated by male or female unless you felt it had to be.
No, I don't. I don't, ladies.
2020.
Year of the
woman.
Year of the
Independent woman. Year of the Entrepreneur Woman.
No. Whenever Beyonce did Independent Women, that was the year of the Independent Woman.
Oh, okay.
This is so the this year of all women.
Of boss
we,
women.
We believe all women.
Boss women.
I'll ask you a question about that later, then.
Oh, okay.
If you believe in all women.
All women. No, that's what they say. We have to believe all women. I got some questions for you. No, that's what they say.
Oh, believe all women? Nah, all women. I told you, I don't believe nothing until I see the facts. I don't believe nobody automatically.
So you see the whole facts?
Gotta see the whole facts. What a great episode, huh?
Yeah.
Huh?
Facts.
That was one of my favorite episodes. I'm not going to lie. Definitely. That's up there with episode 13.
Yeah. Go check those out.
We definitely can't take shots on the show.
Yeah, we got to chill out with the drink.
Got to chill out.
So, so what did Wendy Williams say about Nicki Minaj? You want to play the clip? Because it was messy.
Let's just play the clip.
Apparently, the way the show is going today, we did not have enough time to get to Nicki Minaj's brother. But let me tell you something, Nicki. That's going to be my first story tomorrow, and I'm going to lead with this. You should have never married him. Because now you've ruined everything about what your brand could be again. You're never going to stand a chance when you're with a man who pulls a knife at rape point, you know, and you're never going to stand a molester, a registered sex offender who wasn't even ready. You're never going to stand a chance with John Q. Public, because there's only one thing worse than touching children and pulling knives, and that's murder. By the way, he did go to jail for manslaughter. Oh, I think I just did the story. Nope. Get to digging. There's more on it. Everybody get to digging. Okay. I made a mistake and called Nicki Minaj's brother instead of husband. But the brother's already in jail for, and so.
She fuddled over herself, but, yeah, so you heard the clip, and
you think she's gonna take that
she's
back?
Ultimately talking about Nicki Minaj's husband, like she
at her brother.
Well, like she confused the brother for the husband, but she altered like it works. She also said she was gonna talk about the brother too.
Yeah, she also touched back. She came back. She circled around.
Yes, but ultimately she's like, yo, you're not gonna get the look in the public that you want because you're married to somebody who's a. Somebody who raped somebody and
allegedly was he convicted?
I mean, yeah, he's a registered sex offender.
Okay, I'm trying to find out these facts.
And he also served time for attempted murder. So she's like, yo, you're never gonna be the activist voice that you think you might be right now or whatever because of the fact that. Like they're like, yo, there's only one mm-hmm. thing. She was like, there's only a couple things worse than touching babies and touching kids,
which is killing people,
and you've also done that. And raping somebody at knife point. So, yeah,
these are crazy accusations.
So yeah,
I mean, he's served time. He's been convicted of both, so it's not they're not
he's been convicted of both.
I mean, he served time. He's a registered sex. He just got locked up.
He's been convicted of murder too.
I mean, attempted murder. He did time for attempted murder.
Wow. She really wanted a thug. Meek wasn't enough.
You heard Meek. Meek was like, yo, I never should have tried to save her.
I thought Meek said, told y'all.
Meek was like, I never should have tried should've to save
said. Her. I told y'all, niggas. That other nigga's weird. I told y'all. Actually, I don't want no problems with you attempting to murder niggas. Whatever.
I hope none of that shit is true.
Yeah, but ultimately, he's in the news right now, or they're in the news right now, because he failed to register in California with the legal Megan's system, law. And so he got locked up for it.
Okay, so he'll be out soon, right? Or is that a big deal?
It's probably a big deal.
Because if you're a sex offender, I'd imagine not registering is the one thing you got to do.
Yeah.
So you didn't do that. There's got to be a stiff.
Yeah,
penalty for that. But you're rich in America. If you have the money, I can like probably pay a fine or some shit.
He's rich.
Going to jail. He definitely got locked.
She's rich, and that's her husband. So yeah, he's rich.
Well, now,
no. Once you marry,
not when these.
I don't know if they signed a prenup. Once you get married
in public, they're married.
They're not married.
I'm saying I have to take them on their word of them being married.
They're really married.
They said they're married.
They said they got married.
Oh,
and he's saying that's her husband.
I need the facts.
You need the facts, the paperwork? You need to see the paperwork?
I need to see the paperwork. Nah.
We'll try and get that.
Chill.
We'll try and get you that.
So, hold on. So, let me go back over the facts of this case.
Yeah, let's go.
The facts of this topic right here. Nicki Minaj,
mm-hmm.
her husband just got arrested for some sort of... For not registering for his sex offender status.
Right, where they live.
Her brother just got arrested.
He didn't get arrested. He just got found guilty of... raping a 12-year-old. Yeah, he's doing like 20. I don't think he's. I think he's waiting sentence.
I think he got sentenced.
I think it's 25 years, right? 25
something years? Crazy. So we'll figure out exactly how it is. So her brother's locked up for this, and her does she? Is that something?
Is that an indictment on her character?
You think there's something there?
I think it's something to look at. Honestly, definitely.
Wow, think that's a coincidence. It's just a coincidence, or is there something there?
I mean,
it's some sort of conditioning.
But she's like,
she's not even picking up on it. Mm-hmm. But there's something there. Because you know, they always say that you always go back to your family. Like,
oh, come on, man. Let's just say that.
No, they say like your wife is really low key your mom. Or
has traits.
Yeah, like there's a lot of, you know what I mean? So maybe she just feels comfortable around a certain energy and it just happens to be that this energy
is around.
It's coincidence, man. It's just around
people who are. Right.
Coincidence?
Yeah.
All right, we'll move on. Coincidence.
It's a coincidence. Yeah, Plus the whole Wendy Williams thing.
Wendy Williams is dirty, though.
She's just using that to boost her sales. You know what I mean? Like,
it's going
to
work.
She's a shock jock. Yeah. Type of talk show.
And it's going to work because she's going to respond.
Yeah, you know Nicki got her own shit, Queen Radio. So if you say some foul shit about Nicki, you know she's coming back with the fucking guns.
But if you don't have Apple Radio. You don't have like
she got Queen Apple. Radio. She gets if
you
Apple,
have, like,
numbers,
Apple Radio, you might not be able to hear it. Wendy Williams is on like channel 7 or channel 5. Like, all you got to do is put a bunny ears on
the
TV.
All right, so let's see if we can. If we do get some feedback from her, from Nicki on her radio, we're going to see the views, you know.
Okay, it's definitely going to be a back and forth. I just don't think that Wendy Williams had any business to go that crazy like
Wendy
that.
Wendy Williams has.
I felt like she was being super. She went over and beyond.
Clearly, there's something between them that we don't know. Yeah,
because that was unnecessary. It felt like a cheap shot because that shit happened like 2 weeks ago, right?
What, the arrested?
Yeah,
something like that.
Yeah. So why now? Why everything all added up and piled up right now?
They have so many fire topics that I mean.
That's why it's just
so she has so many fire topics.
Or she didn't have no topics and she just went crazy. Oh
yeah, no. She has a lot of fire topics. She calls it what, the tea?
Because I felt like it was extra.
She has different teas. She drinks all that black tea.
Nothing.
What is the other one? Chamomile tea. She's been drinking all them teas.
Oh yeah, she be going crazy.
Exactly. So
it's people, the same shit that people hate her for.
Yeah.
The same shit they hate her for, they love.
They love. Keep That's why they sit down and they watch her.
And even the way she said it was mad disgusting to me. I felt mad nasty. Like, bitch, just say the shit then. Like, if you want to say some shit, just say it. She's like, I'll tell you next week. Like, bitch, just say the shit.
Yeah, come back next week. Give me that view.
I'll tell you tomorrow, maybe. Yeah.
If Nicki responds, trust me, glory. I
mean, she has to respond.
Jackpot, bro. And then she is going to. Because Nicki knows
like a
callar.
She's a person who influences enough, enough women pay attention to her that I feel she has to do something.
Could you date somebody that was a sex offender? Could you forgive that?
I mean, it all depends on the type of sex, what it was. Like,
she was pissing at a school ground late night, and the cops pulled up and saw her. She was pissing out there, but since she was exposed by the school, boom, sex offender.
Nah, I can't fuck with her. Get this
dirty bitch out of here.
Dirty joint.
What about you, Bleak?
Yeah, but
it's a joke. It's a joke. I could definitely.
I mean, it has to be, bro.
Can you forgive her?
I mean, she has to register. She had to use a bathroom.
You're gonna have to tell people.
We pull out everywhere, bro, and take pisses.
You can explain the story every time. You know, she was taking a piss by the schoolyard. It was not like she fucked somebody.
Yeah.
You gonna tell them the story?
I mean, I'll.
It's not personal.
I mean, yeah.
Okay.
I mean, like, we'll have a conversation about like the comfortability with it, and
What if she was 19 and she fucked a 15-year-old nigga?
Oh, no, that's all right. That's okay.
I might dead her because she's getting G'd by 15.
That was mad long ago, though.
I'm just saying for that little stupid reason.
Now, what if like the kid
let a 15-year-old G it when she's 19?
What if a 15-year-old
get out of here, shorty?
A 15-year-old, you couldn't G a 19-year-old?
I'm not talking about him. You're asking me about her.
I'm okay.
What if she was getting bullied?
Okay.
And this 15-year-old came through and showed some support. So she
reciprocated
the love.
So you could do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Think about it. She was like, oh my God, they probably got to know him. He's probably a virgin. And she was like, I got you, boy. Boom, there it is.
And you're okay with that?
Of course I'm okay with that.
Okay.
Are you cool with shorty pissing in the schoolyard after hours? In a sexual
Am I cool with it?
I mean, are you gonna continue to get to know her or bag it or wife it or whatever? I'm sure it's in the beginning stages of.
If it's in the beginning stages.
Yeah, are you going to continue to talk to her?
I have to hear the story and I have to believe it. Uh-huh. If I don't believe the story, then there's no way.
How else can you be registered as a sex offender if you're not actually doing the act?
That's mad ways.
Okay, like
all right, let's say this. Oh,
does anybody can? There's mad ways though.
What if it's a young teacher, new teacher, right?
Okay.
She gets caught jaking on her lunch, playing the banjo on a lunch break.
Oh my god!
Principal walks in or something like that. Somebody
snitches.
No, I'm saying somebody walks in and sees
the wrong person walks in.
The process says now she's registered as a sex offender.
Okay. Can I forgive that? That's a tough sell.
But you said last week that it was cool if she was at work stringing the banjo.
Yeah, but you got to secure the jake.
Got him.
You got to secure the jake. So y'all, dumb niggas. Y'all the niggas that be like, oh man, I'm gonna jake right here. Let's go.
What? I mean,
anybody can walk in. Anybody's there. No, when you go to jake, you secure the jake. You got to make sure, like,
she did secure it.
This time, this window.
Let's say she thought it was secure.
She thought
it was secure.
Obviously, she thought it was secure.
Things happen.
The mistake.
Mistake.
So, little mistake. Play the banjo. Very nice.
Very nice.
Okay, so she got caught playing the banjo at school.
Right.
Oh my god, she's a disgusting bitch. I can't explain this to my mom. How can I explain this?
Yeah, great. Yeah, you have to explain it to your mom.
Like, what the fuck?
She's gonna be like, man, this choice in women. So what do you have, so you
can't.
Son.
She was masturbating in school. I can't tell her the truth. She pissed behind the schoolyard. She pissed behind the schoolyard. No, but it's a public record. What? They can just look you up on the internet and see what you did.
Yeah.
So you can't lie about it. You might as well just tell the truth. Yeah, I'm gonna have to pass on. If she's playing the banjo at school, wait a minute. Hold on. Okay. I got a question that can make it all right. How old were they? No,
you can't make it all right.
Doesn't make it's it school. All right. Makes it worse.
Yeah, we're not a university.
Oh, man. Because if it's a little kid school, what if a little kid came in and saw it? That's what started the process.
And yeah, she's a dirty. Him, and he's been like, what are you doing? Playing the banjo.
And then I can
teach you.
And then, no, and then you hear her trying to get her off. Like, yo, let's just play a little bit. Don't snitch. Just.
Oh, my God.
And that's crazy, right? That makes me think
it's crazy when you see, yeah, it's crazy when you see the 30-year-old women teachers having sex with the 8-year-old boys.
Yeah, y'all wildin'.
You'll just know you know that nigga's game is crazy. First of all, he's probably wild fresh.
All the Aspikash.
All the Gap, all the heat.
Baby Gap.
You feel me? He's probably wild fresh.
Ooh.
Right? Come to school bringing a fire food every day.
Fresh bowl cut.
Get a fresh cut every time. Mad little.
Adorable. No peach fuzz.
Yo, adorable. Man, chill out, bro.
Nah?
Yeah.
I mean.
Nah, but I'm saying, like, when we were growing up, there was a couple teachers that we had the hints of, and we kind of knew what was going on, but we was like, you know. But it was like, we was 14, 15, 16, 17.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm not saying that's right, but.
That's like every 15, 16-year-old, that's like a dream for them.
Yeah, I mean, I knew it was a thing because it was happening. But we were like, oh, you know what I mean? That's an attractive joint. This, you know what I mean? We're like 15, 16. We know what's going on. We're doing it anyway.
Yeah, man. Mad horny.
But nowadays, they be fucking like 10-year-olds.
Nah, right? Go on your logo. That's too much.
Why does that happen, though? What does a 10-year-old say to her? Because sometimes they be married and all that. Like, and what does the chick, like, how does he bag it?
She'd be scooping. Like, they be getting caught in, like, the know, parking like, lot at the Walmart. Or whatever, like, at nighttime.
Now,
you know that example
you ever
that
had, you ever had those new Danimals?
Supports my what I was saying.
I got
last
2020
week.
Snacks.
Yo, 2021 you ever snacks. Had the sour apple Go-Gurt? That shit brand new, baby. How do you bag? How does a 10-year-old bag a 30-year-old woman with a car?
With a husband. Who got a husband?
You have a house and a car.
Because
you can buy all the toys you want. You don't need his toys.
You can buy all the last week, G.
You can buy all the prostitutes you want, too.
Yeah, exactly. What you're saying supports what I was talking about.
Talk to me.
And when it's fucking obsessive.
Okay, now, see, this is a scenario we just made up. Because the reason why...
You like that, Chris?
So women who jig 3 times or more a day are susceptible to raping little boys.
Oh, my God.
Is that
God.
What you're saying?
Nope.
Is there a correlation there?
If you have to do it in school, if you're a teacher and you have to play with your banjo...
So I have to leave school.
You
then.
Have a problem.
I have to leave school then. Like, what if I go problem. To the parking lot?
You have an obsessive problem.
So you're cannot jake during the day. You have to
find
wait
another
till
way
home.
To release endorphins. Find another way.
I'm trying to release.
Yo, let's nut. Let's get back to these.
Can I release a nut?
Hold on. Let's not get too far from what we're talking about. How do grown women
get bagged by 10-year-old men? 10-year-old boys.
10-year-old boys. No, they don't even get bagged. They bag the 10-year-old boys.
Yeah, they school them.
Because the boys be like,
that's a mental illness. Then that's
a mental illness. I'm gonna show you.
There's something wrong with them.
I'm gonna show you.
The ones that are doing that.
These 8 year olds aren't trying to take down these teachers. They get taken down by the teachers.
I think there's a couple like little cool 8 year old niggas. Like, yo, I saw a movie one time. I want to try this. Can I try this? And then, you know, she's just there lonely as hell. Like,
what do you, well, in the, like, in the 30 minutes while niggas is eating lunch, she's that lonely?
Oh, shit. You got the phones in your size?
Nah, if you out here thinking a 10-year-old is fresh, you definitely got problems.
I mean,
you have problems.
If the 10-year-old's fresh, I'm sure the father might be fresher. Like, go for the pops, if anything. If you're going to go after anybody.
Maybe that's how she's going for the pops, like word of mouth.
Nah, because you end up bagging the 10-year-old, man.
Feel me? Sometimes you got to put the work in, yeah?
Yo, dad. Whoa.
Yo, dad, you coming to parent teacher conference? You got to come. This shit is lit. The top is crazy. Nah, see, okay, we're talking about little boys, man. Yeah. That's not right.
If a teacher has to do that rape in school, little boys. I'm telling you.
Don't do it.
They just have a problem. That's it.
Yeah, okay, man.
So no raping. We're all against.
I'm all against for logging.
So, but let me ask you a question. What if you found out that your son?
What?
What if you had a son and you found out that your son was sleeping with his teacher?
No. Oh,
but he's keeping it light.
No, pops. Yo. You can't,
I'm
bro.
I'm busting down my teacher. I'm getting straight A's right now, and she's buying me shit.
Oh nah, you gotta stop down. That. You gotta stop that. You gotta stop.
15.
Yeah, man, I don't want to see that happen, man.
No,
yeah,
nah, dad. I'm busting her dad. Like, it's already happening.
Yeah.
Like, her shit fits to my shit now.
Bro, you gotta stop that.
She's leaving her husband in 3 years.
Man.
What?
You're a bird.
She said next year when I can get my license, she's getting me a baby C.
What?
C-class? Yeah.
Get out of here. No, you got to stop that immediately.
What are you doing? I failed you as a parent, yo.
Yo.
Failed?
Yeah, yo.
You wouldn't be like, yo, let me talk to you, little nigga. Yo, let me talk to you, my nigga.
What are you going to say? What are you going to say?
You better be knocking that pussy the fuck down, my nigga. You better be knocking it down. What'd she buy you? Huh? Let me see that. Huh? Okay. That's this year's shit. That's this season's shit. That's fire. Okay. But you got to get the big bread. Tell her you want the cash. You want cash, actual cash. Deeds, property, shit like that. If she really love you, she gonna sign all that over.
But how do you convince him not to like her? How do you convince him not to fall in love?
Okay, and if I didn't... No, he's not gonna fall in love.
Yes, he is. He's 15 years old. Let's go. He's 15, my nigga. You crazy?
But there's such a thing as nature, like...
Nature.
Like, when one side is on dick like that, sometimes automatically makes you off dick. Like, so he'd be loving it at first, and then she's so on dick, he'd be like, yo, this bitch is.
Nah. Oh, I'm saying one out of. Dumb? I'll say like
she's
one out of.
Oh, she's actually 10, doing whatever
one
I
out
say.
Of 10,
oh,
okay. 12 guys or nah, kids I can do at that age will feel like.
Buy
that.
All my niggas kicks. Or I'm telling. Right? That's how.
So extortion. You're gonna teach him extortion.
Extorting a woman.
Yeah, you're gonna teach him extortion. Let's go.
I'm not down extorting women.
Yeah, bro.
2020, year of the woman.
I'm definitely
not. Year of the independent woman.
Yeah. Shout out to y'all. get him.
Nah.
Get him.
Let me ask you a question.
All right, another.
So you're saying it's extorting her.
Yeah. No, that's what he said. I was just making a joke off of it.
She was raping your son.
I said I wasn't down with it. You were cool with it, though.
I'm not cool with it.
No, you were. You were just like, yo, get the guap.
It has already happened.
No, you're like, yo, you got to get the deeds.
Yeah.
You got to get the
money.
The real estate.
Yeah, you got to get the.
Don't get the kicks.
Hold on.
Get the cash. You need to get
the cash.
You need to get the cash.
The cash. Get the
tax free, baby. Like, no.
Nah, bro.
Yeah, we see you.
You know what I mean?
Green. I see why you got the green on.
Oh, man.
Nah, because it's, you know, it just matches.
Uh-huh.
But, so she's raping.
Matches the inside.
She's raping your son. It's already happened.
I said I wasn't cool with that.
Hold on, let me just get this thought out.
Oh, my bad.
You're good. She's raping your son. It's already happened.
Mm-hmm.
And all he got was a couple pairs of eights.
Mm-hmm.
You're disgusted.
Mm-hmm.
You got eights. You could have got 11s.
I don't understand this.
You could have got fours. You could have got threes. You
I can't.
Nines.
Carmine.
Sixes. Ones. The greatest. The ones.
Nah.
You could have got those.
I can't.
And you're out here getting eights. That's why you got to raise your children well, man. You got to teach them the important things.
I think it starts with the parent on this one.
No, I was going to say, G's right. You got to teach your kids the values. Know the value of Jordan. Know the ranking of Jordans. Eights are at the bottom. If you're going to give up the dick for Jordans, don't ever let them be eights.
Yeah.
Nines, fours, threes, elevens, sixes. I mean, the classics. We're talking. The
fives. Now we're talking. Now we're talking.
Right.
But to be... Okay, we back out from the jokes sometimes because sometimes people, this is your first time viewing, listening, whatever. Yeah. You're going to be like, these motherfuckers are crazy.
Yeah.
And I don't understand why they have a show.
Okay.
But we'll walk it back a little bit. They shouldn't be having sex with teachers.
Oh,
right?
Now we're
going to. We know that, right? Oh, yes. We know that. We're not down with any kind of grown people having sex with little kids. That's wrong.
Yes.
Now that we know that, that's how we really feel about it. Mm-hmm. We'll continue with what we're saying.
Hypothetical speaking.
And if he was to already have been having sex with her.
Well, see, you're the way you're already saying it is making it like he has consent. She's taking the consent from him because he's underage.
Can a 15-year-old have consent?
Not against a grown woman.
Can a 15-year-old have consent at all in anything?
Oh, in anything, yeah.
But not in sexual things because they're not old enough.
It's because that's especially no.
They have consent with each other because a 15-year-old boy can't rape a 15-year-old girl and not like suffer the consequences of rape. There is definitely consent, but when it comes to and I guess in the American legal system, when it comes to adults into having any type of touching with children, it's against their will. And they don't like it's
because
not even
they can't give consent.
Yeah, they can't give consent but against an adult.
But if your parents are cool with it, you can get married at like 14, 15, 16.
Yeah, but they got to sign that paper.
But your parents can let you get married, but you can't have sex?
Yeah.
I'm not saying I'm for 15-year-old sex.
Doesn't make sense. Because once you're married, you're handed over to your husband.
And that seems like archaic? Like that seems wrong.
But that's what marriage is.
But hold on, you know, that's cultural too. Let me not even get into that.
People used to get married way younger.
It'd be deals between families.
The bad thing with that would be arranged marriages. Mm-hmm. And not, because if two 15-year-olds are in love, yeah, they could definitely be in. What? They could definitely get married.
Can two 15-year-olds be in love, man?
I'm just saying, if they both say that they're in love.
Yes, but was I in love?
Yes, you were in love.
Think about all the girls that you were dating when you were 15.
So what about
besides 1% of us, they're all gone.
So what do you think about the guys?
Are they really the one you love?
Yeah, you love them at the moment.
Oh, you love them the most still, right? They're your one true love. I'm just asking you a question.
I loved them at the moment.
You loved what you thought was love at the moment.
Yes, that's what I said. I loved them at the moment.
Okay, but now looking back, was that love?
It still was love.
Okay, fire.
Yeah.
It might have been a amateur or a baby version of love, yeah, but exactly. It's still love. Like I mean,
I never forget.
Yeah, to love,
I'll
to
never
feel
forget.
And
that appreciation for another
I don't love
person
you anymore.
Yeah, I don't know what I forget what the thing we were talking about was.
Blood exchange.
Yeah.
But put us back on track. I got an opinion for it.
That's what's up.
Teachers, fucking teachers.
Oh, yeah, so let's get. Yeah, we've been hanging out of there? That for
yeah,
a while.
Bro. Okay. If you agree, yeah.
Oh, you like it.
Don't even bring teachers it back. Don't even, let it dead. Yeah, it's dead.
Get it out of here. We out of here.
We had enough stuff on that?
No, we're done. We're done. Jeez.
You told them to get the money.
No.
Get the money.
No. I got the bags ready.
Oh my God. Oh, there's going to be wild coronas on the table now.
No, but just not even use that. I'm not even talking.
No, we're going to use it.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Let's go. R&B.
You want to do that?
You have the list, so you say whatever one you feel flows in.
There's so many good shits.
Whatever flows
coming
in.
Coming from
good.
The teachers and fucking and raping. Yeah. It's been all SVU the first 30 minutes of the show.
Man, this is crazy.
And it's so like, this is going to be disgusting. They're going to hate us for even joking. You can't joke about having sex with little kids.
Yeah, they are.
Why can't you?
Because it's very disturbing and delicate. And it's touchy.
It's wrong.
It's wrong.
Of course it's wrong.
So yeah, so that's why you can't joke.
But we can't make any jokes about R. Kelly now, forever.
No, we can make jokes about R. Kelly.
Oh, no. No, you're making jokes about what happened versus what trying to create scenarios in which they get done. Yeah. I think that's the difference.
All right, so two big albums just came out. Actually, three big albums.
Uh-huh.
We can go Reggie Mid Loud, or you can give a little 1-2, maybe some songs you want people to listen to, okay. Or just however you feel about it.
Yeah.
I'll start with the first one. Mm-hmm. Lil Baby's new album. What's the name of his album? Mm-hmm.
Lil Baby's album, My Turn.
My Turn by Lil Baby.
Fire.
So 200K out the jump.
200K out the jump. How we feel about that?
It's a fire album. It's fire.
Yeah. This is Sour, Loud.
Oh, Reggie Mids Loud.
Reggie Mids Loud. I'll say. You see, this is crazy because I don't think it's.
You don't even have to rate it like that if you don't want to. You could just give you a little how you
it's
feel.
It's Fire Mids.
Fire Mids?
Fire Mids.
Is there such a thing as Fire Mids?
Of course.
Okay, Fire Mids.
It's in between. You know what I mean? It's
good in between.
Yeah.
Almost there.
Yeah.
20 THC.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
TH level, is THC level 20.
Yeah.
Damn. 21.
What do you think, G?
Little Baby. I'm going to sit on it, pause a little bit longer. I liked it from the first couple listens. I probably listened to it like 10 times already. I like it. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. But so far, maybe I got to sit with it a little bit more. It's not, I don't like all the way through, all the way through. And usually I like that with shit. Yeah. But maybe just I need some time because what happened to me was some other shit dropped.
Uh-huh.
And I kind of...
You're just a little bit. You're a little bit bigger fan of the other artists that dropped.
Not even a bigger fan.
Yes, you are. Like, yes, you are. Yes, you are.
I'd say you're a bigger.
Come on. G. No. You're not gonna do that, G.
I like it. I think it's really good.
You like the other artists?
Rating for it, or
I'll give it a loud rating.
Loud.
Yeah.
See, I think I would probably also give it a loud, even though I feel like I haven't even experienced it like I was supposed to yet.
I want to give it a loud, but
I think I'll give it a loud. The beats was fire, and he does be saying something. Half the time he'd be saying something. So
I think that's a slight.
That's a slight?
I think that's your way of knocking it down a tier.
That was knocking it down?
So just I think say that's fire your, no, I think no, that's no. a subtle G way of trying to knock it down.
Yeah. I wasn't knocking it down. So? I was saying like
you don't even look me in the eye.
Contrary to popular belief, he'd be saying something.
Okay. I mean, who's saying nobody's saying he's not saying anything.
Yeah, can I just set it up the way I want to set it up so I can throw the jazz in there?
Oh, I mean, this is a blunt exchange. Why are you trying to pussyfoot around it?
I'm not even pussyfooting around. I'm just making it sexy.
That's why he's Mr. Tap Dancer.
Just making it sexy, baby. Just dancing for y'all. Just making it sexy. But now, Lil Baby.
You know Crumb's going to keep it honest for you.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you're going your way, your truth.
Keep
living in your truth.
Keep your feet to the fire.
Oh, my God.
I feel you. But yeah, Lil Baby, good album.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, he hasn't really, you know, disappointed the fans yet.
Yeah, no. His projects have been good so far.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's nice. So, what else dropped?
Uzi, I don't know which dropped first, so I don't want to disrespect.
The Bad Bunny dropped first.
Oh, before and both of them?
Yeah. No. Bad Bunny was after Baby.
Oh, it was after Baby. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So, Bad Bunny dropped, right?
Yes.
And Bleak, you be our specialist for this, to be honest.
Ooh. Thank you.
How do you take it away, man? Explain this. Do whatever you got to do.
Loud?
Loud?
Yeah, definitely loud.
Like super loud.
Super loud.
Like moon rocks.
Moon, like
sun rocks.
Skyrocket.
Sun rocks.
Toad.
The
toad.
With the keef on Billy top of Kimba. It, with the wax.
Yeah.
Wrap it up in some other shit. Uh-huh. What are you going to do? Roll it around in some other shit.
And then put the oil
and
over
then yeah, and then just dab that shit or something, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Keef, no?
Dab, keef.
Yeah?
Dip.
Make a all drink that. On the side and then wash it down with the, you know what I mean? No?
Yeah, all of that.
So, best album you've heard in a long time?
Not like that, but.
His best album.
Well, his last album was a classic, too, so it definitely is.
Is it better than the last one, you think?
It's just as good, yeah, like better. And I don't want to say it's better because they're both, it's good. Like, they're both.
So really is he elevating or is he
Yeah,
like...
he's definitely elevating because he definitely changed. He tried to, you know, he hit some high notes.
Uh-huh.
He changes rhythm a few times. So that was awesome. So that made it different. And then the fact that it was hot, just like the last one, gives you an extra boost. Like, damn, this thing. He's that good.
Is it all in Spanish?
All in Spanish. He definitely raps.
So he just broke some records.
Fire.
Some words in English. Definitely he definitely did his
most
debut.
Most sold for the debut for all Latin albums.
Fire, yes, fire, sir. Fire.
Something like that.
Hell yeah.
Most streams. He also got what? Most streams for the debut, whatever.
Uh-huh. Yeah. That's fire. No, that's fire.
So like he has the most, so like more bigger than like all the like all Ricky the Glacier.
Yeah,
Shakira,
we'll find the
honorable. The honorable mentions were Shakira, Ricky Martin.
Ricky Martin, my fault.
Yeah.
Any notable?
You said Iglesias, yo.
He's trash.
Nah, which one? Enrique Iglesias?
Nah, he's nice.
He's nice, yeah.
Ricky Martin, he's trash, right?
No, he's good money.
He's good. Any notable features? Like, what's your favorite song?
Oh, Deadass. I wouldn't say the whole album, but he has this song with 25-8 is fucking fire, hella bars.
Nah, chill.
That's the name of the song?
25-8 is the name of the song.
That's grime. Why 25-8, that's my man song.
That is that's a dub work song. That's a dub work song. That ass. That's why I probably like it even more.
Yeah, that 25-8 dub work shit is fire. Yeah.
Inspired. And if you ask him, he likes that song too.
Oh, yeah. That song been out, so you feel me?
Yeah, dead ass.
So that's cool. That's fire.
Okay, and so yeah. I mean, I wish I could understand. Like, he's one of the guys I'd be like, damn, man, I want to understand more, man.
Yeah, the beats are fire.
The beats are OD beats fire.
Sounds crazy.
The beats and the flow's
like,
fire.
You know, he's a Spanish trap rapper. So you know what I mean? He took that whole shit and like took it to another level.
Right.
Heat. So you definitely recommend that.
Definitely recommend.
And if you don't know what that is, you're probably
a weirdo. Yo Hago Lo Que Me Da La Gana is the name of it.
I'm not trying to jump out on a limb, but I mean, I don't know if it is he one of the, like, would you say he's like top five Spanish rappers of all time?
Yeah.
Already?
Already.
Fire.
Already, because he invented.
Is he better than Daddy Yankee?
He's just as good as Daddy Yankee.
Is he better than
Daddy Yankee? He elevated Daddy Yankee because he, just like Daddy Yankee, created a sound.
Fire.
You understand? Like, he did everything. Everything he has supposed to do, he did it. Like.
I hear Daddy Yankee's like the Gucci Man of Spanish.
Yeah, bro, music. And he's Spanish still doing music. He's got a song with Daddy Yankee on that album. And it's really good, too. Like, OD5. Fire.
Daddy Yankee.
Yeah. Yo hago lo que me da la gana.
Oh. That means something fire in English, right? What's the translation?
I do what I want.
That's it?
Yeah.
I thought it was like, I do whatever the fuck I want.
I do whatever the fuck I want, yeah.
Dig.
That would be even more fire if, if that's what it meant.
And then third,
what else came out?
Uzi's. I don't know. Did Uzi or Meg's album come out?
Nah,
first?
Uzi, baby. Meg's came out too? No, Uzi, man. You know, G was that Uzi?
Nah, like what? Meg?
I don't know. Who came out? Which one came out first? I think, or the man that came out the same.
Who?
Same.
Meg,
week,
Meg
same
day, nah, man. Uzi, man. Come on, G. Stop playing around. Stop dancing, man. Stop dancing.
What's dancing?
Get to it, bro. Who's Get dancing? To it.
Have you guys heard
your favorite album that just dropped? Yeah,
that's not my favorite album.
Your new favorite album right now?
Yeah,
is that your new shit right now?
I'm just asking you a question. Have you heard it?
Have you heard what?
Have you heard the Lil Uzi Vert album?
I haven't heard entirely. No, I haven't. I just got back from DR, so
not yet,
I haven't gotten my chance.
Have you heard the Lil Uzi Vert album?
Yeah, I've heard of it.
You've heard it?
Yeah, I've heard it.
How did you feel?
I fuck with it. It's another fire album.
You see? If Crumb fucks with it, then I'm sure I'm going to.
This is great music. I care about like God, music.
Look how he's taking us through this.
Yeah. All right. What do you think? Yeah, I don't even want to say. What do you think?
Pardon me?
What do you think, G?
About the album, G? I know you're like holding yourself back, backflips and all that.
Know.
Like he's like,
I don't know why I would do that. That
makes sense. Because that's your man.
Yeah.
How is that my man's? I don't even know. This man. It's an artist.
You fuck with him as an artist.
Hold on.
Like you fuck with his music. Don't that's your man's.
No, I mean, I didn't say I didn't fuck with Uzi, but like you're asking me how do I feel about the album.
Yeah.
What
is it called again? Eternal
Attacker?
Yeah.
Ooh, fire.
I was definitely gonna butcher that second
fire.
Part.
No, you weren't. I think so far, I mean, I've only had it for a few days. So I've only heard it like about 70, 80 times.
Okay.
I think it's a good mixture of the beats. The production is amazing.
Yo, I fuck with a lot of that.
Yeah,
it's like Mad Toonami. If you're into like that,
exactly.
Cartoon and
all the extra little shit in the background. Great production, of course. Uzi, great lyricism.
Okay.
And almost nobody rides a beat better in this day and age.
Okay.
So flow,
like he's up
wave,
there.
Flow,
like he's
like just the ambiance. He's an ambiance guy.
He's
up there with the Travises that just set the mood. Like, all right, we're about to party. Everybody chill out.
Yeah, nah, this is good time music.
Yeah, we're going to have fun now. Stop it. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. Like stop all this sad
Come
shit.
On.
Come on. We're about to turn up.
Let's have fun. And even if it's sad, it's going to sound beautiful.
Right.
But it's pretty good. I'll give it a loud.
Yes.
Super loud?
Super loud, right? Super loud.
Loud plus.
It's pretty good.
Oh, man.
Good shit.
It's all right.
35% THC. Huh?
35% THC.
What?
35%
THC.
Yo, say it with your chest, little nigga.
Where we go?
35% What you said 35?
All you guys are
good? Yeah, just, what is it?
So you guys are all good with the album? Good?
Do you have a favorite song off the album?
Oh, yeah. There's
too many good songs on the album.
So it's all of them.
Lo Mane is mad fire. I know that's a lot of people's songs, but Lo Mane is fire. Great
song. But that's not your favorite song. I know that.
Nah.
Nah, that's, you know.
I know you got yours in the bag. Yeah.
Pop is cool. That's
like that. What's it called?
Yeah. You gotta dance. That's
you like that. Silly wrist.
Silly watch. Not that.
Oh, silly
that's
watch.
A fire.
Oh, silly watch.
But
bad.
That wasn't him.
Not it. It's okay.
It's okay. You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. You don't want to reveal that to the.
No, man. It's a lot of good songs. Baby okay. Pluto, of course. Fire.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Feel that.
I'm Sorry is a great song. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Chrome Heart Tags. It's whatever. Have fun, man. So it's a great album.
Just say the whole album. Your favorite song is the album.
It's a good song.
Your favorite song.
The album
is
a good song.
Exactly.
So,
the album is a good song.
Did you happen to hear Meg Thee Stallion's album?
Yeah, I heard Meg Thee Stallion.
What's your thought?
Meg Thee Stallion, a solid work. You gave them what they want. That's what they wanted. And you gave it to them.
What is this? What was this? I didn't hear it yet. What's like the subject matter for her project?
Fly bitch, getting money, doing her thing.
Uh-huh.
Sexy as fuck, shaking her ass, driving the boat.
Okay.
Boss lady getting the money.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
So she likes.
Fire.
Yeah.
What's up? Did you hear it?
I haven't yet, no.
Yeah.
Are you gonna hear it? Do you plan on hearing it?
I'll give it a try. I always do. New music is always wanted. You always need new music.
What do y'all think about this new wave of like stripper rap? Like stripper trap.
See, hey. I don't have anything against strippers.
Exactly. And if they trap and they go rap,
you know how like the gangster rap was a specific lane that you went in?
Or you think
like,
there's a specific stripper lane?
I think there's a specific stripper rapper lane now that with a lot of female rappers that are coming up with like...
That's fire.
Their music is like in that specific, very, very specific lane. Like, yeah. For people that are like, in that lifestyle.
It reminds me of Future's Humble Beginnings.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Strip club music.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's made some of the greatest strip club music of all time.
Exactly. Humble Beginnings.
He might be a...
Corona. Corona.
I'm going to kick some of these off the table.
Yeah.
Yo, it's not Corona. I smoke weed. It's not Corona.
All right.
Got on.
Yeah, he has some of the best strip club songs of all time. But this new strip club music wave by the strip club hoes.
Uh-huh.
I mean, strip club women. Year of the Woman 2020.
Boss. Independent.
Sometimes it's just too much for me. It's a little bit, and I like to consider myself a very easygoing man when it comes to some of this, the way you talk and your terminology and shit. But mm-hmm. some of these ladies are disgusting, and I cannot do it. It is not right. When you're talking about how the wet is, I get it. I like it, but
what?
It's too much sometimes. Okay. What do you feel about that? Yeah. You love this. You be in the club going, bitch, I put my legs behind my head. Like, yo, all right, shorty.
Like, got this nigga sucking on my pussy.
Everyone can hear you. They can hear you say this stuff. Why are you saying this out loud?
Yeah, man.
Stop it.
Got him eating on my ass and he's and he flies me out here and he licks me up with diamonds and
damn, if he licks you up with diamonds, then I get it. That's big money.
Yeah, bitch. Do your thing. Boss bitch.
If you write that for a bad bitch, that's a hit. Right now.
Most of these women are having dudes write their songs where that like
crib mad horny like mad. First I'm gonna suck on his dick. Yeah. I like that.
It'd be mad male fantasies like
pussy.
Like I saw a video on YouTube yesterday about like the cool girl and what and like movies and how there'd be like the joint that's down to drink beer, down to eat wings, a million wings and never gains weight. It'd be watching football and down to be with the niggas. And like the person was like, these just be mad men writing these male fantasies, these like semi homoerotic fantasies, like where they just want a female version of their man.
This one thing, hope their nigga has a vagina.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Please.
Chill.
Yo, please be a girl in disguise. So I can smash. You freaky man. Alright.
Oh man. Yo.
Yo, man.
Yo, so
they just want a shorty as like lay up and play smoke blunts and play video games with you.
I always wanted to know what that's like. Because I've had shorties that play video games.
Yeah.
But, like, I always wanted to know what it'd be like to have a shorty. Like, yo, all right, let's start the season together. Like, let's really go in every night when you come home. But that would be mad trash.
Nah, that wouldn't, bro.
If your girl wants to do
yo, that. Yo, I'm trying to work on my career, yo. Get off.
Oh, hell no. Shit, career time. Wow.
Unless you have two TVs.
Oh, you need the two TVs. Yeah, you need the two TVs.
Nah, see, that's a whack ass. You need your girl to be like, yo, get the fuck off the game and come get this pussy, you stupid nigga.
Right.
She's still going to tell
you. If your girl
that.
Is also being like, yo, just pick up some Cheetos, yo, we have the fucking Gears of War going right now.
Yo,
I'm in
she's
a,
still
I'm in a party right now.
She's still going to do that, though.
It's like, yo, what?
The chat is lit.
The chat is lit right now. I didn't cook. I'm killing in 2K right now.
I didn't cook, babe.
Pick up some Domino's.
I didn't cook, babe. Just bring up some pizza.
I'm on a 15-game win streak.
I'm running over there. I want to see that. I want to see that.
Kills. I got 50 kills.
I'm running over there.
Baby, I got 50 kills and no losses.
Fire.
You love that?
I love that.
I think I'll throw up.
And she still tell me. She's still going to tell me to come fuck her. You know, while I'm playing.
She's mad nice. Like, no. Yo, baby, you can just
because obviously she's going to go to bed before
if you want to,
you
can just stick it in. I'm just going to be playing, though.
Oh.
Go ahead, do your thing.
Yeah, let's go. Headshots, headshots.
No. I'm playing the game.
UAV.
Well, stand to the side or some shit.
UAV, all of that.
Yeah. It's smoky in this bitch, though.
Hell yeah.
It's back to the old days. Yeah. We kind of chilled out for a little bit. What happened?
I don't know.
Anyway, we back.
Cameraman.
Blunt Exchange Boys is
cameraman
back.
Cameraman was
know.
Blowing it down, too.
Consent Boys in the building.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to all the dead niggas.
Yeah.
And the niggas in
what?
Jail. no, the dead niggas that we love. We shout out the dead niggas all the time. What's wrong with you?
And every time I have the same reaction.
Dead and gone.
Shout out to the dead niggas and the niggas in jail, not the pieces of shit.
Yeah.
Do you niggas think that it's inappropriate to listen to R&B music when you're just around men? Can a bunch of men be listening to R&B music? I'm not talking about some singers preparing to sing some shit. Niggas just chilling. Yo, put some music on. Boys to Men.
Yeah, nah, I don't want to hear that. I don't want to hear that.
Put some music
Crumb
on.
Don't want to hear that R&B when I'm with my dudes.
Yo,
Janet Jackson.
Boys
nah.
to Men.
Nah, I don't want to hear that.
Room 112.
Yeah,
sick,
there's no point. There's no point.
Carl Thomas.
Yeah, what are we doing? Yeah, I'm not down with that.
Put the Carl Thomas on, like, yo, this shit is crazy, right? I'm in my. Ooh.
Yo, put that on. Yo. Yo, put that Omarion on. Yo, put on that icebox.
Put that icebox on.
And if you put that on, shorty,
put that groceries
you know,
on.
If you put that on, you know how shorty going crazy. But if you with
there's
your
no,
niggas,
no, there's no shorties.
Niggas,
there's no shorties. So who's going crazy?
Yeah, there's no shorties. What are you talking about?
So niggas can't appreciate fire music together? Niggas can't appreciate R&B music together? That's inappropriate?
That's it.
Not new age R&B music. Not like.
Not anything sexual.
Not anything newer than like 2001 or something like that.
For real?
Or 2000, no, maybe not. I mean, I'm not going to say 2001. I'm going to say like 2012 or something like that. I feel like there's been a major shift.
Though?
There's a major shift in R&B music.
So I'm asking you a question. So if you like the song, right?
Yeah.
It's a song that you like.
But I'm not
you can't
also,
listen
but
to
I'm,
it in front of a nigga.
What?
So you can't listen
why
to Chris Brown?
Why can't you listen to it in front of a nigga?
No.
You can't listen to Chris Brown?
If it's on, I can definitely listen to it. I'm not walking out the room. I'm saying I'm not putting it on. I'm not putting it on.
The question for me is, a nigga comes over, like, yo, B.
That nigga comes over, too. I don't like that sound.
Your man's.
Yo, I might need to get a new man's.
Your man's comes over, like, yo.
Because that nigga might be trying to...
Your man's like, yo, let's go for a spin, my nigga.
Let's go for a ride.
You feel me? So you jump in the whip, right, my nigga?
Go for a spin. Hey,
and, yo, my nigga, let's go pick some shit up. You know what I mean? You sliding?
Yeah.
Nigga, like, all right, I'm out with y'all, right? All right.
Okay.
So we, you know, we bend the block, right?
Uh-huh.
You
know what I mean? Oh, man, you bend the block. All right.
He blasts the music. Like, he's like, yo, I got some new shit, my nigga. Turns it up mad loud, right?
Right.
And there's some Tevin Campbell shit, like, like he's blasting it, like, puts the windows down, you pull up on some bitches and they look at you. She looking back at them. Blasting the R&B music.
Oh my God.
And they be like,
fuck is that nigga doing?
I support pride. And they give you the
that's what you shit. Got.
No, I'm lying about the last part. So, but he blasts the R&B music. How you feel?
I mean, I'm not trying
to
listen
to turn it off. Yeah, like, no, man, like, yo, man, uncomfortable.
On, I mean, I'm not going to say that. I'm like, why are we listening to this? Let's turn the R&B music off.
Like, this
off.
Shit is fire.
Why? I mean, it is
horny
a good
or some
song.
Shit? Why can't I gotta turn it off? You horny?
Nah,
is it making you horny or some shit? Why I gotta turn it off? The song is fire. What's wrong with you?
I don't like listening to R&B music
around niggas. Dudes. Yeah. Why? Because you might get fucked. Like,
hey, yo, what?
Like, what? What's the problem?
I don't want to listen to
fuck
it.
You because the R&B music is so lit.
Oh my god!
I like listening to R&B music with
a woman,
with a woman,
or by yourself,
or by myself.
But with a man's around, no. Now it's bad. No. Now it's poison music.
I mean, it's
not poison music.
It's
uncomfortable music.
Yeah, it's uncomfortable music.
It's uncomfortable.
Hey,
no, because when you listen to R&B music, you get horny.
It's not uncomfortable.
Is that what happens?
No,
that,
no,
no. It's not. I'm not uncomfortable. I choose. I don't want to hear that. I don't.
Left, we want.
I don't want to hear R&B music when I'm with my dudes.
If a nigga puts on R&B music, that's a problem.
Chris Brown be like halfway rapping. Chris Brown.
He puts the guy on. R. Kelly. That's touchy. It's too soon.
The Weeknd.
No. I have. Yo, I.
There you know what
you
I mean? That's R&B.
All Party
these
next
people,
door.
All these people have come out, like I said, before.
Drake.
Hold on. Like
Post
I said.
Malone.
Like I said, all these people have
Party
come
next
out before.
Door.
Justin Bieber. He puts on some Justin Bieber.
Justin Bieber's
Justin
pop.
Justin Timberlake.
Justin Bieber's pop.
Okay.
And Post Malone is pop.
I thought they have R&B shit.
Wait, no. Post Malone
they might
is
sing,
pop?
But they don't. They're pop artists.
Wow.
Okay. So.
Good for him.
Pop, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to be really white to get into pop. You can't get into pop if you're black. It's going to be R&B. Urban or hip hop or R&B or some shit like that. Or unless you like, you got to dress different. Like, you got to get the, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I guess.
You know what I mean?
You're a little Nas X swag.
You're terrible, man.
If that's what you're country, saying. I didn't say
country.
That.
Like, you see how he's able to get, he dresses like super country to be able to be considered country.
I misread you at first.
I hate that.
I apologize. You got to admit when you were wrong, Corona.
Yeah.
So.
Corona.
Corona. What was you just talking about? I had a good
R&B music.
Oh, yeah.
Not listening to it.
So hold on. So
with
hold
my
on.
Dudes.
The problem is with your whole theory about not being able to listen to R&B music with your
like, name. I'm not going to say. No. I, for the record, I want to say, like, stuff like.
If you're feeling uncomfortable, that's something.
No.
Like,
no,
what is it?
No.
Let's like, break it down.
Hold on, I say.
If you can feel uncomfortable because of a song, then what is it? Like, what's going on? What's the deeper issue here?
What's the deeper issue here?
Does the R&B music make you want to fuck?
New R&B music be just wild, vulgar.
It gets you
new
horny.
New R&B music, in my opinion, is a lot more dumbed down than it used to be. It used to just they used to use a lot
I agree
more
with you.
And better metaphors. I now agree. It's just a lot of like
put the dick in the pussy now.
Yeah, I don't want
it. It used to be like you can ring my bell. So like ring my bell. What's the ring my bell? But now it's like yo, fuck me, bitch.
That's the kind of R&B music that I don't really want to hear. I don't want to hear that when I'm with my dudes. But like let's say Stevie Wonder, like that's just good music because I can listen to that all day.
Because the metaphors.
Cause it, yeah.
If it's too direct,
if it's,
you don't
if
want
it's
it.
Just like,
you don't
want
to hear the word.
I'm gonna put my
yeah.
If it's R. Kelly,
and
child's
with my
play.
Dudes,
I'm thinking child's play.
Why? Because wow. You're imagining whoever's around you has
no,
to suck dicks.
No, I don't want it.
Because you hear the
no,
word.
No, that's not what
dicks.
I want to listen
so
to.
So what's
it.
The problem? Yo, that's the part I don't get.
Yo, I don't want to hear.
So you hear a song about
R&B music with my niggas? That's what I don't want to. If we have a choice of what music we could put on, I'm not.
You'd rather hear vulgar killing
I'd rather
and
hear
drug
that.
Dealing
I'd rather hear
than vulgar
that.
Having
rather,
sex with
yes,
women.
Yes.
Did you see how
yes.
insane that sounds?
Cool.
Why does that
you,
sound
what would you rather hear?
Whatever the fire shit is.
No. If they're both equally fire.
Yeah.
Sometimes I want to
hear
the
R&B. What's your preference?
Sometimes I want to hear the R&B shit. Sometimes I want to hear the hip-hop shit. But if you want me to pick one, I pick R&B for the sake. Go ahead. R&B, I pick it. I like R&B more, so I play that.
Cool.
I come through to my nigga's house and be like,
I know,
yo,
you do.
Listen to
you
this.
You do. Yeah. No. See,
listen
that's cool. See, that's cool.
Oh, because her doesn't make you horny.
She's it's a female.
But the R. Kelly shit will make you
I
horny.
Don't want to hear a dude talking about
getting his dick sucked. But you can hear a rapper say it.
Yes,
no, that's not the focus
it.
Of the shit.
Yeah. Because the
he's
singing
not, he's
is
not,
make
the,
you horny.
The shit isn't focused, and that's I don't be listening to wild just suck my dick rap music neither. So that's not in my weird.
Isn't that
weird
rap music?
Huh?
Isn't that regular rap music?
Nah. Rap good rappers make throw it in the metaphor where you're like, I don't need to hear,
right?
Suck my dick.
Okay, so you know what's funny though about that? You know what's funny about that? Because it's the shit with bachata. if you're in a group with a bunch of dudes and you're listening to bachata the entire time with a bunch of dudes, after a while it gets funny. Because like, bachata, the in bachata, to, yeah, like, bachateros
dance with a woman.
Not even so, that. It's that bachateros, sing so the about music. The most hard broke, like some, that some bitch broke their heart, like into pieces.
Like some wimpy.
And that's
shit.
Usually the topic in every bachata. So that nigga's heart was destroyed.
On some wimpy man shit.
Yeah, some woman came through and left him for dead.
Yeah, that's sounds...
You know, so the nigga's talking about some sort of pain at all costs.
Yeah, that music be the firest music, though.
Exactly. So,
low key. That's my favorite kind of R&B music.
If you should,
like the super sad.
Yeah, see? That's cool.
That shit is the fire shit.
You show up to somebody's house and a bunch of dudes and they're drinking and listening to bachata.
Listening to R&B.
Take your sad vibes out of here.
The niggas is crying.
After a while, bro.
But I want to play the sad vibes with the niggas.
You want to just play the fucking vibes around your niggas?
Nah, like whatever the firest joint is. Like, listen to these chord progressions.
No, but you're choosing the... You're gassing it.
Oh, D.
Do you hear the timbre in the voice? These runs are amazing. Mm.
You're gassing it.
Yo, I seen a meme that said, men cheat because outside pussy is easier to get than inside pussy.
Ooh. Wow.
I've heard that before.
Many times. I've heard that many times.
Let's talk about it.
Yeah, let's talk about it.
Do you feel like it's easier to get outside pussy than inside pussy? Can a nigga answer that question on the Blunt Exchange?
Yeah, for some situations, I definitely think it is. I think for some situations, it probably is. And then I think if it's being taken care of at home, then it's probably less likely that you're looking for even, like, you have the extra energy to throw that out there crazy to be able to do that. But, I mean, I definitely think there's people who don't get anything at home that it's they get attention at work. They get attention, like, in their regular day-to-day. If you're not getting attention at home from your significant other,
you're going to find that.
You're going to find it somewhere else. And you're going to... Yeah.
Sometimes they don't even seek it. Sometimes it finds them.
Yeah.
Hmm. It's like a vibration that you lead out, like a, you know, like a pulse.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you need that. And some people pick it up. Some, you know, us men, we are very good at picking that up. So, yeah.
All right. I agree with what you're saying for you.
I believe that to be your truth,
and
my brother.
I feel like that's the truth for many of us.
Tip my hat to you, sir. Good sir.
What about you?
What about me? What? Will?
What? Do you think it's easier to get outside pussy rather than inside pussy?
I feel like it can.
That's situational.
But like that's like a situation where it's like, if it's hard for you to get the inside pussy, that means there's something wrong with the sex drive, right? That's like another viewer question that came up.
Or
that
might be something with the same relationship, shit. Like, or just there's something off in the relationship.
Like, because the other question that was part of this was, how many times do you think in a relationship you should be having sex in a week?
Mm.
Let's start with that, and then it goes right back into that.
Yeah,
right.
How many times in a week during a relationship should you have sex?
Wow.
Or is the minimum
amount
for healthy sex?
Well, if I have to say the minimum, it should at least be one time. If it's a minimum. But
you
I know we're not trying. I know. I know.
You can do
I know
one
it's
sex
not
a week.
To,
that's
no,
acceptable
no, no,
for you.
No.
One sex a week
we're
is acceptable. So I said, what's the
so
minimum for a healthy...
For myself or just in general?
For you.
For you.
Yeah,
damn, that's super pressure.
Malik, you want to answer? If he says it's super pressure, give him a second.
No, yeah, give me a second.
Okay.
How many times in a week do you think is healthy? How many times a week should you be having sex in a healthy relationship?
Well, this is it, right? So it starts with the fantasy first. The fantasy, you know, when you live in the fantasy, you'll say 5 to 6. Because, you know, you like your shorty and whatever, so you want to do it as much as possible. Plus, as men, you know, we want to always have sex. So, but realistically, I think 3 to 4.
4 times a week?
4 times a week.
Minimum? I would say, like...
Healthy, 4 times a week.
That's minimum.
Four times a week?
Or that's the number.
I feel like two for minimum.
Two for minimum. You can go 6 months with two times the sex a week.
No way.
No, I'm just saying, you're just saying at a minimum, and then at a maximum. The
minimum means that you will accept that. Like, yeah, that's acceptable. I mean, for 6 months, could you have sex times a week?
I'm just saying if circumstances make it that we're only able to do it for two times at this current time, then I mean, like,
I'm giving you a 6 month window that you would have to live.
Someone is traveling.
Traveling. Let's say work. Yeah. I mean, I could. Yeah, like,
this man thing.
Especially if it's my significant other, then I'm gonna be able to work with whatever we can do at that time.
So two.
If it's based off of we're both like actively trying to do it whenever we can do it. Mm-hmm. Versus plus, like somebody who's trying to withhold it for like other reasons.
Plus,
there's nothing stopping you guys from having sex.
Okay, yeah. So besides then, so yeah.
YouTube. But remember, you got to give up a week every month.
Why?
I mean, if she's not, you know, you got to give up a week once a month.
What are you talking about? A real man loves his woman every day of the month.
Ay, Dios mío. If you're that type
of
person,
a real man loves his woman every day of the month.
If you're that type of guy, know what I mean? Cool. Hey, that's cool. If you're that type of guy, cool. But you
turn the shower on. Warm water.
There's a week that's up in the air. That's on you. That's at your own risk.
Okay. If that's my shorty and she need that, I got her.
Okay.
Okay, so then how many times a week for you?
How many times a week for me?
Yeah.
It's crazy, like, what I want and what I'll accept.
That's what I'm saying, yeah.
That's what
yeah.
I was trying to ask y'all. I don't know if I asked it, right? Because
you
I didn't
did.
Get... Because
I said it. That's what it says. Based first on the minimum, fantasy.
Yeah.
How many times? What's the minimum? Well, what I'm on. Two different
yeah,
ones. But whatever.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying.
Three, four times a week.
Okay.
Minimum. Yeah.
Nah, it's got to be four to five.
But I'm trying to go somewhere else with it. But if I get three, four a week, I'll be all right.
Eight times a week?
Bro, like.
Because then you got to think about those days that you were at home.
There's going to be days that I'm not smashing. And that's fine.
But there's days that you sometimes might make up for it. Because
but some days I might get three,
twice.
Four times.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. There's times that you might smash twice three times in one day.
So are you considering those each different times?
No, that's kind of one day.
Right.
Every time I say a time, I'm meaning a day of sex.
Okay.
Hours. I'm not going to cheat. If I had sex with you four times today, that doesn't mean we're good for the next 2 weeks. Like,
No. I'm just, you know what I mean?
No. That kind of is one day, one smash.
Yeah, but if you smash four times today, she's not going to let you smash tomorrow.
That's not true. If you smash the right time that four times today, then you already know.
She's swollen, bro.
She might be swollen, but there's ways around that.
Nah, there's no ways around that.
There is ways around that.
Okay. You're gonna beat it up all week like that, bro. By the end, she's.
I think G might be talking about getting top as counting as.
Oh yeah.
A day of sex, if it's just that.
Yeah, I'm about to be wilding out. We being grown together. We're adulting.
No.
They call that adulting.
No, I think that's what it is.
I get you. I wasn't thinking about the top at all.
Yo, so.
What is unacceptable?
What was the numbers? Yeah, what was the numbers?
I said 3-4, but like, you know, I want
4-5. I said 4-5.
Yeah, you know what? I'll go with 4-5 with you. I agree with you. 4-5, and that's like the minimum.
Yeah,
I need four times a week.
Every day is a maximum.
Seven days is maximum. I don't even want 7 days.
Now,
so then why would
there's gonna be a day I'd be like, don't touch me.
Why wouldn't the maximum be maybe 5? Because that's what you could really do and could do consistently do that. Versus what if minimum's
that's why I said
four or five. If
four
minimum's
five.
4 or 5,
yeah.
Then
you said minimum's 2. I can't do that.
No. I'm leaving it open to something that's how I interpreted the question as in
Okay.
If at worst, then it better at least be just that.
But if you have a good connection too, and you and she's good money, you good money. That number can blow up.
But do you think that's why a lot of men cheat because they're not getting that minimum number that they need?
Yeah, that's different.
And that attention, that sexual attention, so they go outside.
That's
because
very different.
That meme that piggybacks off that is mm-hmm. outside pussy easier to get than inside pussy because mm-hmm. you know after you've been with a woman for a long enough time, sometimes it takes a little bit more to rev that engine back up.
If I don't take into any consideration and just on my personal being and then it's 4 or 5 something like that. Like I was just taking it into real life considerations, but if it's just on what I feel and then.
Okay. Yeah. So, you know, it takes a little bit longer for a shorty to get revved up after y'all been together for a while. So do you think it really is easier to get outside pussy than inside pussy?
Yeah, I think it can be. Yeah, I think it all depends on the relationship that you have.
Do you think that's why? Do you think that's why? You know, those the dudes that cheat. I don't know what's wrong with them. The ones that do that. You think that's why they do that?
Yeah. I think that's one of the reasons.
That's definitely that's a reason. Yeah. I've heard it many times.
Definitely, like, yeah, not getting attention or not getting the
and vice versa.
If you don't get attention at home, do you think it's
and vice versa?
And if you don't get the attention at home, do you think it's okay for him to?
Corona.
Him to, or her to, whatever side of the relationship it is. So, you know, go get what their needs are met. You know, they have a bond already.
And
you know,
stay in the relationship.
Together, like, we share bills, we're on the lease. I'm just going to go get, like, you don't be smashing right. I'm just going to go.
So now it's a you don't be smashing right versus...
Or you don't be smashing enough. I don't know. You don't be in the mood for me or something.
No, yeah. It would have to be that. Not smashing right because...
Because you could work on that?
I mean, that wasn't part of it.
All right, so take it out. So, you know, you're not smashing enough, whatever. Right. You don't seem to be interested.
I think it's all right to go outside the relationship? Nah, I don't think it's all right to go outside the relationship to get that.
So you would be pissed off if you...
Or just end the relationship if it's not getting what you... If you feel you're not getting fulfilled in that area and it's not up to your par.
They're not giving you enough sex during the week.
What happened? The cameraman got me laughing.
So you wouldn't step out in a relationship just because you're not getting your sexual needs met.
Right.
I'd rather
rather break the relationship.
What if you're in it's a tough relationship, like you have a lot of money tied up together, it's not an easy way out. You're gonna have to, no matter what, you're gonna have to be with her for another year or 2 years.
If that's the case, then I'm gonna try and work on that.
Yeah, but she's not giving you no push. She's like, you don't get me wet like that no more.
Oh, then we over. It's over.
Give me the rest of the bread. You can get out of here.
What rest of what bread?
Because we have shit engagements for the next 2 years.
Oh, like, I mean, we could be the roommates.
Nah. Yeah. You don't want to fuck, so you don't want to be together, so get out of here.
Nah, you get out of here.
No, man. Get out of here.
Nah, you get out of here. I feel safe now. So do I.
Let's go. Let's see how this works out.
Yeah, let's see. I call the cops first.
Yeah, that's smart. Call the cops first. But you're still like 6'4".
5".
Whatever you say. It's your world.
No, if she tells me that, then I could definitely can't, like, we're not continuing, and I'm working towards
getting out
ending
of
this relationship. Yeah. All right.
So let's say that you did step out and you're like, fuck it, I'm gonna step out.
Are you what are y'all doing?
Are you I can really answer that.
Hmm? Are y'all step
Would you step out?
I mean, no, that's not even the question. Would you step out? That's crazy. Question, no, right? We don't cheat. Black men don't cheat. Yeah. You're the woman, 2020.
I love the women. No cheating. Boys.
What I am, no, what I'm saying, do you think it's ultimately easier to find pussy outside than inside?
Outside pussy can be easier to get, but sometimes the lasting effects are very dangerous.
Uh-huh.
And they're not worth it.
Right.
What were you talking about?
Do you think outside pussy is easier to get than inside pussy?
Yeah, that's very situational.
Very situational.
Yeah, true. Very situational. But and the circumstances sometimes call for that, yeah. Uh-huh. And it is easier.
So you say sometimes the circumstances call for it. So do you feel it's cool to...
I didn't say the circumstances call for it. I just said that I think it can be.
No, I'm expounding on this and saying that... Do you feel it's okay to step outside the relationship if those needs aren't getting met? Like, in your case, you said 4 to 5 times. So if she's not trying to have those relations 4 to 5 times a week, would it be cool? Do you think it's okay? Maybe not just you. Let's not put you on it. But a person who would require 4 to 5 times, do you think it's okay if they step out of the relationship to get those, just to get those sexual needs, but not for any other type of
Listen, if you're gonna do that and you need to feel like you need to do that, then just do it in the most respectful way possible. You shouldn't be getting caught. It shouldn't be nobody.
Of course, I agree.
You should just handle your business the way you need to handle your business. That's how you're gonna go about it. Me personally, I'm not that kind of man. When I'm with my woman, I'm with my woman and my woman only.
Okay. Oh, so I could have sworn you were just trying to give me some side eye for saying that literally two seconds ago, that I wouldn't go outside the relationship. I'd rather break up.
I just want to hear how you feel.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
I'm not down with stepping out. Step on a woman? A woman? What kind of monster do you take me for? But,
wow.
Yeah, it's out of control.
I know.
I love women.
2020
year of the woman, consent boys approved and endorsed.
Boss.
Yeah, so what if you found out that your girl was stepping out because you weren't giving her enough tool? You weren't laying the tutelage.
Yeah,
and she was upset.
You was playing too many video games.
You was playing too much. You had the 50 kill streak.
Oh.
Yeah.
And she went out to get some
real kills.
Yeah.
Yeah. She get her top blown off.
I mean, she had to. You playing video games?
Yeah.
Or you eating pizza?
And you find out, right? Mm-hmm. And you've been cheating the whole time.
Oh. Right? You've been stepping out. You got a gamer. You got a gamer joint.
You've been stepping out the whole time. Would you expose her on it? Like, would you like, yo, call her out? Like, yo, I found out you was cheating, you raggedy bitch. You funky dog head bitch.
Yeah.
Because I would never cheat. So if I happen
the situation, oh, I see. Ooh, listen, you can't tap dance if you don't like tap dancing. And if you start tap dancing, you better respect me, my nigga.
No, okay. I'm just saying.
I'm Gregory Hines, the great dance legend. Don't get in my game if you don't know what you're doing, baby.
I'm just saying, if somebody was I don't know. Ultimately, would I call them out on it? I don't know. Like,
for the sake of the question, you have to make a decision, my guy. Would you call them out? Yes, or no?
Probably. If I was in that situation, I probably wouldn't.
Okay, you just let it rock. You knowing that somebody else is dicking down your girl,
like currently, or it happened.
It's happening.
It's currently happening.
Yeah, you know she's cheating.
Oh, then
now she cheated. She's cheating.
In this scenario that you've created,
yes, in this mystical world.
Am I still cheating? Or did I cheat?
I mean, you're currently cheating. I'm not like you might not fucking somebody right now, but you know you're open to it. If it happens, it happens. I'm still doing my thing.
She's actively cheating,
but
I'm not.
She just got something lit right now. You just don't got a link right now.
I'm searching for it.
You're always searching for it.
Okay. Well, then, yeah, I probably wouldn't do it. I probably wouldn't say anything.
Just let her rock, because it's your cheating.
Yeah.
You cheating, I'm cheating. It's a tie.
Yeah, I wouldn't call her out.
What about you think, Bleak? You cheating, I'm cheating. It's a tie. It's all good.
What's the point of being in the relationship?
Because you got bills together, big bills.
Okay. You got big bills.
Yeah.
So
you're going to leave the apartment and pay her the 15 racks for the next 2 years? Mm. Or the 7 racks this year, 7 racks next year? You could just get out of there and pay her the racks.
What racks are you talking about?
Some shit that you have a lease for 2 years.
Why the fuck do I have to pay that?
Or then pay the penalty. You have 10 racks right now?
What penalty?
Oh, you're just going to get out of there.
I'm out of here.
Your name is on the paperwork.
I don't understand these penalties you're talking about.
The name is on the paperwork. You're just out of there?
I'm out of here. Yes,
they're eventually going to take that shit out your check, my nigga. Eventually.
What check? What are you talking about?
Okay. All right.
I know. Is this something I don't know here?
Yeah.
This is your girl.
Uh-huh.
So ultimately,
there's cheating going on both ways.
Is your name on the lease?
Is my name on the lease?
It's your girl. Of course your name is on
the lease. Yeah, my name is on the lease.
All right, so that's what he's saying.
Oh, okay.
You can't really just get out of here. That's what he's saying.
I mean,
we've been over this lease question,
it messes up your credit.
Okay.
It messes up your life.
All right.
For how long? It takes your money away.
How long is your credit messed up?
Yeah, they'll take all that money away plus extras.
Whatever. I don't know.
For how long is your credit would be fucked up?
A while.
Well, it depends. You know,
for about a year, right? For about a year?
7 years? Oh, my Lord.
7 years?
7 years.
I'll take it.
Real nigga shit.
Bacon.
I respect that, though.
Yeah.
I kind of respect that.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie to you. Yeah. I respect that.
I'm out of there.
Okay. So I mean, fuck you, you funky doghead bitch.
Yeah, you play that game. Fuck out of here.
Oh, hell yeah, my nigga. I'm out of there on that. Nah, I'm not. That's not me. That's Bleak. Me, I'm a woman. I respect women. 2020, the year of the woman, I respect them.
Independent.
And if she wants to cheat and I'm cheating, who am I to judge her? You know what I mean? I just hope it's not no lame niggas, man.
So you wouldn't, would you say anything?
So hope it's one of my mans.
Now we're judging.
Would you say anything?
Hope it's one of my mans, like, because I fucked with them niggas.
Would you say anything to her?
That we could all chill. It'd be light, it'd be easy. We could smoke L's together. Right? Because it's my mans. Like, you wouldn't rather you be your man's like, yo, who you fucking? Oh, Steve. Geez. Oh, all right. All right. That nigga cool, my nigga.
I mean, if you didn't even...
got the best Fonto.
To be honest, though, if
you
you're not...
You going to Brooklyn every time.
You want your girl...
You're getting the Dark Jones.
You want your girl the Dark Jones. Your man's because he got good Fonto?
That's my man's. That's my man's,
That's
my
crazy,
nigga.
Right?
You hear this? This
the
nigga.
First thing you said was, yo, he got the good Fonto.
Yeah.
I grew up with this nigga.
That's something big for him.
Nah.
You'd rather be some strange nigga.
I mean, I'd rather...
You don't know nothing about this
nigga.
I'd rather
her not be cheating. Shit.
She's cheating. Nice try. She's cheating already. But that's the
crumb. Crumb.
She's already cheating. There's no way around it.
Nigga, wouldn't be cheating.
If you a dude that's not piping your shorty, that's it. You a lame, so do you deserve it?
What if your dick's not doing the, what it's supposed to do? You have to take the Street Fighters and
Wait, so you're talking about like
you
what?
Pop
like,
a Street Fighter you got like and a, get the half a V-boy.
What is it? You have erectile dysfunction?
ED.
Yeah, I think that's what it's called. You
that's
can call
what
it
it's called?
ED.
ED.
That erectile word is erectile word is mad vulgar and disgusting.
It's not ED, but I did just see a tweet about there's a new dating app for dudes.
Oh, niggas with little Jones.
Yeah, dudes with little Jones. Like, yo, ways so to find
dinky,
shorties.
Dinky ones.
Yeah,
what are we
yo, that, how there's many a, inches there's a new that? Dating site for
how many
men
inches? Three and under?
With little with micro penises.
Three and under.
I didn't
with little
on,
packages.
I saw
with small packages.
I didn't really.
Hey, there's probably no blunt exchange viewers, but if there are some blunt exchange viewers with whatever situations you have, minor situations, yo. They got
so
a new site for you to get all the jokes.
I didn't click on it to see. I just saw it in passing. I thought it was pretty funny.
So yeah, so you got a new
what's
site.
The normal?
I don't know the rules for being having a small joint. I wouldn't know anything about that.
Oh, so what do you consider yourself?
I wouldn't know anything about that, baby.
So what are you...
Will you be signing up for that website or are you good? Oh, no, you are, you're good.
Yeah, I'm good.
But if you weren't good, would you sign up for the...
No.
Oh. Bleak, you. Yo, last week you said some funny ass shit. I didn't even want to say nothing, man. But I'm gonna let it slide, man.
What, man? Chill,
no,
chill,
because
man.
We was talking about shorty masturbating, which I thought was an amazing topic.
Okay,
I like that topic a lot.
Uh huh.
And I was like, yo, what if shorty had the big ass fucking like the huge ass dildo? And my nigga Bleak said, yeah, like 8 inches, and I died.
Yo, man, she.
I died. 8 inches of the big ass dildo. All right, my nigga. I said the big ass
he
shit
was
like booted this.
And
it's like, yo, 8 inches. Yo.
Booted and
7 inches. Whoa. Yo, that sounds crazy, nigga.
Nah, right, I said 8. You sure?
Yeah, it was 8, my nigga. We could bring it back. That shit's funny as fuck. I die every time. Every time. Yo. Yo, I love y'all, my nigga. This is another great episode. We have more shit,
facts,
but I feel
facts.
Like we've been here forever. I heard the cops was trying to look for us, my nigga. The facial recognition might be working.
This is crazy.
But we will always be back next week. We'll try to do better next week.
Yep.
I'm your host, Aim Gunner. I'm here with my man to the left.
Yo, Crump, what's poppin'?
And my man to the right.
Pablo, a.k.a. Bleak.
When we combine, when our powers combine, we become the Blunt Exchange.
Yeah.
Thank you for watching episode 17. Thank
18,
you.
Dog.
19?
18.
Thank you for pulling up. Rolling up, lighting up, and keeping
getting
it blunt.
Blunt.
Follow us on every platform: YouTube, Spotify, Apple Music,
Podbean,
Apple Podcasts, Instagram, Twitter,
YouTube, Facebook, everything. And if we don't know what we gotta get a Patreon.
Yeah, Patreon. We got TikTok.
Oh, y'all don't want me on TikTok. You don't want me on TikTok. I have a game coming up for y'all next week. I'm gonna give somebody money if you can. If you can type in the comments every single word of the day that has ever lived for next episode, I got you with some bread.
So all right, long paragraph. Wow. That's 18.
You don't even have to put in a sentence. 17. Just give me all the words.
Oh,
that's all you got to do.
Oh, that's all right.
Easy. And I'll give I'll give you something nice too. It won't even be that bad. I'll give
that
you
shirt
something.
Off his back.
I gave 25
right?
last time.
Maybe give him the shirt off his back.
Give him the shirt off his back.
No, huh? You wildin'.
Yeah,
autograph.
Maybe one of those fitteds.
Nobody wants my fucking autograph.
Yo,
right now, except for
people
the
might want the shirt.
Nobody wants my my autograph right now. So
nah.
A couple people with autograph signature check.
Yeah,
they need some money. But besides that, ain't getting that. We'll try to do better next week.
Always.
Thanks for pulling up. It's the
Rolling
Blunt Exchange.
Lighten up.
Yeah,
cheer.
Been a blunt.
Cheer. Blunt Exchange.
Cheer.
Cheer.
Yeah.
It's now or never. I'm deep in thought in this cloudy weather. Hitting the sour, but no, I'm a redder. Who niggas make it, I guess time to tell us. My new girl got all my old chicks kinda jealous. All I think about is cheese, yeah, that mozzarella. I'm stuck in the city of dreams, trying hard to get it. They want me dead cause I do all this living. Keep wishing, I'm eating good, deep dishing. She call, I'm MIA, you know I cheat, crip it. So uptown, you know I keep.